Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us talk about bempedoic acid. LDL cholesterol plays an important role where LDL is the low density lipoprotein. It is a carrier for cholesterol. But when this LDL cholesterol is excessively elevated, it can lead to various types of cardiovascular complications. That's why it is very essential to control LDL cholesterol within the limits. Normally, when this LDL cholesterol is elevated, we can make few of the dietary modifications. The diet control can reduce the fat content as well as carbohydrate content. Along with modifying the diet, we can also add fruits and nuts which are rich in fiber so that they can produce a balanced diet which can help in reducing cholesterol. Along with diet control and proper exercise, LDL cholesterol levels can be reduced. LDL cholesterol level should be maintained less than 100 microgram per deciliter, which is the optimal level of LDL cholesterol. But in few of the people, these LDL cholesterol levels are excessively increased and they can be considered as high levels when they are crossing around 160 milligrams per deciliter. So in such conditions, we need a strict control of LDL cholesterol as it increases the risk of cardiovascular complications. But the target of LDL cholesterol depends on the patient conditions and risk factors, and sometimes it requires the treatment with antihyperlipidemics which reduce LDL cholesterol. If these LDL cholesterol levels are not properly controlled, they can affect the blood vessels where this LDL cholesterol can be deposited on the intima of the blood vessel. This reduces blood flow, leading to atherosclerosis, narrowing of blood vessels due to blockade by LDL cholesterol. In such conditions, we can use the statins. We have various types of statins like atorvastatin, pravastatin, rosuvastatin, and still so many drugs are there which are classified as statins because they are having the suffix statin. Statins are well-known drugs which can control the LDL cholesterol thoroughly, but they have few of the limitations. At higher doses, they can produce few of the serious side effects. Particularly, they can affect the muscles, leading to myopathy. That's when few of the people, along with diet control and statin therapy, we need few of the drugs which further reduce LDL cholesterol with low dose of statin. Bempedoic acid is one of such drug which is newly approved to reduce LDL cholesterol levels. This bempedoic acid is one of the ACL inhibitor. It is nothing but ATP citrate lyase inhibitor. This ATP citrate lyase plays an important role in the biosynthesis of cholesterol within the liver. Now, this step is going to be blocked by bempedoic acid, which can increase the efficacy of statin therapy. So, bempedoic acid can be given along with statins in order to lower LDL cholesterol levels. So, today in this video, we are going to see how this bempedoic acid acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. Bempedoic acid needs activation within the liver. It is going to be converted into bempedoic acid CoA by one of the enzyme ACS1VL. Here the term ACS1 indicates acyl CoA synthetase 1. So this is one of the enzyme which attaches the CoA to bempedoic acid. Here VL indicates very long chain. So ACS1VL is a very long chain acyl-CoA synthetase 1. This enzyme is highly expressed within the liver, which can convert the bempedoic acid into bempedoic acid CoA. This is the active form of this medication, which can reduce the cholesterol biosynthesis within the liver. Within the hepatocyte, citrate can act as a source of acetyl-CoA, which is coming from the TCA cycle. This citrate can be converted into ATP citrate lyase, commonly known as ACL. This ATP citrate lyase can further converted into acetyl-CoA. Finally, this acetyl-CoA can be converted into cholesterol by several steps through mevalonate pathway. Now, this cholesterol can be packed as LDL cholesterol, which is transported into the bloodstream and across the cells. Now, bempedoic acid is a ACL inhibitor. It can block this ATP citrate lyase so that it can inhibit the synthesis of acetyl-CoA and cholesterol within the liver. In this way, bempedoic acid can reduce the cholesterol biosynthesis within the liver. This is just like the statins, but statins can act at different step. They can inhibit the function of HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. Thereby, they can inhibit cholesterol biosynthesis within the liver. So, since both of these drugs are acting on the same pathway, but at different steps, they can be combined to produce an efficient control on LDL cholesterol. Now, let us see the precautions of this medication. One of the important precautions of bempedoic acid is that this drug can increase the levels of uric acid, resulting in hyperuricemia. This hyperuricemia or elevated levels of uric acid is commonly observed within first 4 weeks of the treatment, and even it can be extended up to 12 weeks of the treatment. So within first 4 weeks, any increase in the uric acid level should be carefully monitored. And in those people who are having more risk for elevation of uric acid or with any previous history of hyperuricemia or risk of gout, in such people, bempedoic acid should be carefully used. When this uric acid levels are excessively increased, it can affect the joints, where deposition of uric acid can be observed at the joints, leading to inflammation, and the risk of gout can be increased. Bempedoic acid can inhibit the uric acid excretion, which results in elevated levels of uric acid levels. This is the renal tubule. Uric acid can be secreted into the renal tubule through the bloodstream, and for this, it requires one of the transporter. On the basolateral membrane, one of the transporter is OAT2, organic acid transporter 2. So many types of organic acid transporters are expressed. Among this OAT2, it's one of the target for bempedoic acid. Normally, uric acid can be secreted into the renal tubules through this transporter. But bempedoic acid can inhibit the activity of this pump. When this pump is inhibited, uric acid is not secreted, so it is going to be retained within the bloodstream. So this increases elevated levels of uric acid within the blood, resulting in hyperuricemia. That's why in the people with any risk for hyperuricemia, bempedoic acid should be carefully used. Second important precaution is that this drug can affect the tendons and it can produce some tendon rupture. So care should be taken while using bempedoic acid. It can affect the tendons at shoulder and it can also affect the tendons at biceps. It can also affect the tendons at back of the leg. All these are going to be affected, resulting in the weakness of joints and development of inflammation. This is particularly more important in the elders who are having the weak tendons. So in such people, this drug should be carefully used. We have already discussed that bempedoic acid can be combined with statins. But during this combination, the dose of statin should be lowered. Otherwise, it can produce very serious side effects because bempedoic acid can increase the levels of statins, which may lead to development of myopathy. It should be carefully combined with statins at tolerable doses. For instance, simvastatin should be used at a dose less than or equal to 20 mg with bempedoic acid. Similarly, pravastatin should be used at a dose less than or equal to 40 mg. Above this dose, it should not be combined with bempedoic acid. Similarly, this medication is not proved safe in the pregnant woman. So in the pregnant woman, it is not recommended. Even this medication is not safe in the breastfeeding woman. So in such women, again, it is not recommended. Now let us see the side effects of this medication. Bempedoic acid mainly produces bronchitis, upper respiratory tract infections. It can also produce some rhinitis. It can produce some muscle pain, muscle spasm, back pain, abdominal pain and abdominal discomfort. Even it can increase the levels of uric acid, resulting in the gout. Similarly, this drug can also produce some anemia, leading to weakness in the people. What is the chemical nature of bempedoic acid? So this is the structure of bempedoic acid. We can clearly observe that this structure is having the carboxylic acid at two positions. Let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So totally it is having the 15 carbons with two carboxylic acids. So we can write the suffix as pentadecane dioic acid. To this pentadecane dioic acid, at the 8th position, hydroxyl group is present. So we can write this as 8-hydroxy. Similarly, methyl groups are attached at 2nd position as well as 14th position. Totally 4 methyl groups are there. So we can write this as 2-2-14-14-tetramethyl. That is the simple name of bempedoic acid. how it is given. Bempedoic acid is available as a tablet at a strength of 180 mg, and this drug can be given along with the statins, but when it is combined with the statins, this drug is given at a dose of 180 mg given once daily. But the statin should be combined at a tolerable dose because bempedoic acid can increase the efficacy of statins. And this medication can be given either with or without food. So that's all about this medication, bempedoic acid, which is one of the new drug which reduces LDL cholesterol levels when it is combined with diet control and statin therapy. So it can facilitate the controlling of LDL cholesterol levels along with statin therapy, where statins can be used at low dose and the side effects of statins can be reduced along with use of bempedoic acid. This drug can elevate the uric acid levels, resulting in the hyperuricemia, and even it can produce some tendon rupture. So on long-term use, care should be taken to monitor these two things. So that's all about this medication, bempedoic acid. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.